Sometimes the real sleep remedy is the brothers you made along the way. Shivering, Miles gripped his blanket, drawing it tighter around him in hopes that the slight pressure would calm his nerves. It's been thundering all night, and he's starting to worry it won't let up. He was hoping it would calm down enough so that he would be able to sleep, but from the bright clock on his nightstand telling him 3:56 in the morning, it doesn't seem like it will anytime soon. He knows it's childish, and maybe a little idolizing, even after all this time being around him, but he can't help but think, what would Sonic the Hedgehog do in moments like this? Sonic always knows what to do, but Sonic is asleep right now and he doesn't want to wake him up, so the next best thing is imagining what Sonic would tell him.
Sonic would probably tell me something I could do to make myself tired, but what?
After a bit of racking his brain to remember anything that Sonic could have suggested, he instead remembers something Mrs. Wachowski told him.
You know, I've heard that warm milk can help you sleep, but I haven't actually gotten around to testing it myself.
It was a random fun fact she told him a few days after all the stuff with Dr. Robotnik happened. It was when they were finally alone in a room together. And it was one of those moments where you could feel the awkwardness and tension that she just said it in an attempt to make conversation and alleviate some of it. It worked, even though it mostly consisted of them rattling off different fun facts to each other, and Mrs. Wachowski didn't really get half the stuff he was saying. That gave him an experiment. He could warm up some milk, try it, and in the morning he could report back to Mrs. Wachowski if it worked or not. Feeling a lot more calm and determined than before, he quietly slipped out of his covers and out of his room. He didn't feel like putting socks on, even with the cold temperatures of the house, so he hoped that his footsteps weren't too loud. Getting to the stairs, he decided to fly down instead of walking. The stairs were notoriously creaky, even in the daytime, and he didn't want to risk someone waking up because of him. After a quiet landing and a few more steps, he finally made it to the kitchen. The landing seemed unnecessary in hindsight, as he immediately needed to fly again in order to get a mug. This one had an image of an orange cartoon cat's head, the milk carton, and access to the elevated microwave. After pouring the milk in and putting the carton back in the fridge, he hovered closer to the microwave to open it and punch the time in. 1 minute sounded like enough time for the milk to warm up. Staring at the microwave, trying to stay as still as he could while in the air, he saw the mug spin around and
Fox,
letting out a scream, which probably sounded more like a screech. In hindsight, he froze up, causing him to drop and almost hit the ground before being caught.
Well, I apologize. I did not mean to startle you, Fox.
Knuckles said as he adjusted Miles in his arms. Even though Knuckles knew Miles' name and his nickname, which he was still adjusting to as being a nickname out of endearment instead of malice, a reminder that he's just a mutant and freak, he still insisted on calling Miles by Fox, so much so that the title earned a capital F in his head. He still didn't know if it was because Knuckles didn't truly like or respect Miles and this was his way of getting his message across without being mean, and or if it was just another nickname out of endearment. The way Knuckles was holding him right now, he really hoped it was the latter. The way he was carrying him reminded the Fox of all the picture books and the occasional show he consumed as a kid, where parents would hold their baby with so much love, like their only purpose was to protect and care for their child. Miles' thoughts were cut off by Knuckles pulling away from the hold slightly, still close enough to continue carrying him in his arms, but far away enough to get a good look at his face. Miles already missed the warmth the protective hold gave him.
Fox, are you all right? You have been silent for too long. It is worrying me.
Miles nodded.
I was just... Oh no, I should.
He cuts himself off as he wiggles out of Knuckles' arms to fly high enough to turn off the microwave and retrieve the warm mug, too worried about the potential noise to notice the Echidna's attempts to grab at him.
I was just doing this. I was tired and I heard that warm milk helps, but I don't really know, you know. But Mrs. Wachowska told me so I had to try it.
Yes, I understand. Fox, please come down from there. I do not want you to drop the liquid.
Being cut off, Miles looks down to see the Echida holding his arms out for him, making what Sonic once referred to as grabby hands at him.
Ah, yeah, that seems like a good idea. Wait, you want some? Cause I can do another mug.
He offers while luring into Knuckles' arms again, melting into the immediate warmth he brings.
No, I do not require your earthly remedies, as I have no issue with my sleep schedule at the moment.
He said as he led them up the stair, tilting his head in confusion at the conflicting statement, the fox took a sip before saying,
Then where are you? I didn't wake you, did I?
He couldn't see the Echidna's face, so he couldn't notice any shift in expression, but he did notice how he slightly tensed up, making him tense up before attempting to wiggle out of his arms again.
I'm sorry, I should have been quieter. I didn't mean to wake you. I'll just go back to my room.
Knuckles carefully tightened his grip on the fox and stopped once they got to the top of the stairs.
No, you do not need to apologize, as it is not your fault I was awoken. I have learned to be very alert while training on my own, and I am very sensitive to my surroundings. This is not the first time I have been awoken in this house, as I have found it is very noisy.
Well, if you say so, I guess.
I say to not worry about me, now.
He paused as he shifted Miles to look him in the eye again.
Do you truly wish to go back to your shared dwelling with the hedgehog?
He smiled as Miles giggled at his comment.
Or do you wish to stay with me?
The fox took another sip of his milk.
Is it he can't I stay with you tonight?
I would not have offered if I did not wish for you to accept.
Then yeah, I want to stay with you.
Miles never really got to actually test and see if the warm milk worked. His experiment was kind of run, as he never got to take more than a couple of sips before he fell asleep in the warmth of the Echida's arms. He didn't really mind, though. He could tell Mrs. Wachowski about it in the morning and they could test it out another night.